Hello guys, today on Monkey's Paper Palooza Craft Corner, we are going to go over craft fairs and 10 tips for success. As craftspeople, we all know that we do craft fairs to sell our wares, whether it be crocheting or card making or paper crafting or whatever craft you do. So let's get into this. The first tip is table and tablecloth. All right, the table is the base of your display. Wherever craft fair you go to, you're going to need a table. Some craft fairs offer you a table, though it may be limited. Sometimes you have a bigger booth. So having a table in place, just in case it's not available, or if you have a larger space that you can maybe L-shape your table, is a great option. Just as important as the table is the tablecloth. Pick something that is not too busy, not too crazy. A solid color is usually best, but it could be any color that fits your items. Bright colors are sometimes great. I chose a canvas tablecloth because it's very durable and easy to travel with, and it made my colors and my cards really pop. But any solid color will do. Tip number two, make the most of your space. Okay, you see in the front of my table, I have these boards. Now, these boards are a great way to use vertical space on the sides of your table. I used some poster board and I covered it with same canvas, as well as put some jute and clothespins to hold my cards and display them in the front of my table. Another great way is a telescopic stand. These are like a photo stand that you get your photo backdrops on. They go very high as well as very wide, but you can use them in back of your table as well as even on top of your table if that's how you want to display your products, depending on what space you have. Tip number three, product display. Do not overcrowd. Now look at this corner. It's a little too crowded, and that was my mistake right there. It made it hard for people to see the cards behind everything. Now look at this side. Now this side is perfect. It gives enough space for people to actually look at the items as well as make it look nice and clean and organized. People are going to be able to look at things easier if it's not overcrowded. So don't put too much product on your table. Also, make use of upward displays on your table. I took some wonderful crates that I got from Christmas Tree Shop, and I put little easels as well as little risers under these easels to give them more dimension. And of course, make use of any little baskets you have, but make sure they're open enough so that people can see what's inside. Tip number four, make price signs. Okay. Yes, you may have prices on your items, but make big visible signs. It makes buying a lot easier for the customer. Also, make sure your signs show any promo prices or sales that you may be offering. Like this one, I offer 3 for $12 for my single cards. And put them on anything you can. I even put them on my board. Because you know what? If they're just looking at the board and not looking at the table, they may not see the sign. And as you see, there is never too much placement of signs. Tip number five, brand yourself. This is super important. Whether you're a little part-time crafter, whether you're a business, brand yourself. I don't care if it says Mimi's Crocheted Creations. Do it because you know what? It gives a name to the maker as well. It tells them what you do. I, of course, put my brand. And making sign for your thing can be as easy as a banner, or like I did, a table runner. All I did was take some linen and heat transfer vinyl that I cut out in my Cricut. Very simple, very easy, but very effective. Tip number six, promote yourself. This is very important. Everybody should have some business cards that they can have people take with them for whatever you do. You can make them really cheap on many sites, including Vistaprint. Another thing is if you have social media, make a social media photo board. These are fantastic. You can use QR codes and have your websites readily available. They can either use the QR codes or take a picture of the frame altogether. That way they always have a way to follow you no matter where you are. Tip number 7, give payment options. Okay, cash is king at craft fairs, but giving payment options is a great thing. Sign up for a free credit service, whether it be Square. I have one through Shopify, but it's a great option because sometimes they may not have enough to buy what they really love at your booth, but they may have a card on them. Tip number 8, give a sweet treat. All right, you may be wondering, what's in this little baggie on the side of my business cards? It is what I just told you to do. Bring a sweet treat. As you see, it was an Easter one, so I brought Easter eggs. Sometimes I bring Andy's mints, but it gives the shopper something to nibble on while they're looking, or if they have little kids with them, it keeps the little kids at bay while their parents are looking. And it brings them back to your table. Tip number 9, have pieces in everybody's price range. Now, you see these banners and these wreaths, they are very high price range. They don't sell as fast, and they're there just for those people that are looking for something like that. But I also have sales and promos going on my table, like bonus deals, like if you bundle things, you get more off. But you can't just always have higher price ranges. You gotta remember the little folk, because they do come at your craft booth. Some of these little folk are under the age of 16 and may only have pocket change. So look at this price range. $2.50, perfect for any child. And last but least, tip number 10, stay busy. Nothing is slower than waiting for a customer to come to your booth. And sitting there with bated breath waiting takes forever. So always bring something to do, whether it's coloring, whether it's something simple you had to finish. It's a perfect way to get some stuff done while you wait for customers. I chose to test out my new markers, which will be in a future video. It's a great way to keep busy, like I said, and you get work done. But also, customers love seeing you at work, because when they see you making something, they go, oh my gosh, she hand makes these. Very important. I hope these 10 tips make you more successful in your next craft fair. I know since I started using them, my numbers have doubled and it really helps. All right, and if you like this video, make sure to click on the last uploaded video as well as a special video curated just for you. And make sure to check out our channel. You can check it out by clicking this link. And remember to like and subscribe.